Hello students, this is Swati Deshpande teacher. Today we'll be covering one more important topic from 8th standard mathematics scholarship. Okay, the name of the topic is area. See students, area is not new to you. You have learned it before. And area is such a topic which is based on formulae. So you must know all the formulae which are there in your syllabus. Because the questions are going to be very very straightforward. Provided you know the formulae, arriving at answer is very very easy. Okay, hardly tricky questions will appear. They will be straightforward, but only thing is you should know the formulae, right? So you by heart all the formulae, whatever is there in your syllabus, it is clearly mentioned in the Navneet book. So go through that. Okay, let's go ahead. The first sum will appear on your screen. In the given figure, the length of a rectangular garden is 30 meters and its breadth is 20 meters. As shown by the shaded portion, rows of 2 meters width are there in the garden. Find the area of the shaded portion. This is the shaded portion. Okay, this entire is the shaded portion. How to find out? This is 2 meter, this is also 2 meter. So how to find out the shaded portion? We do not have the formula for this plus sign wala jo shape hai, uska to formula nahi hai syllabus mein. So what is to be done? We have to take help of those shapes which are there in our syllabus. This is rectangle, bigger one. This is length 30 meter, this is breadth 20 meter. So if first find out the area of this standing position, this its breadth is 2 meter which they have given and length is 20 meter, this length. So area of this which is in the standing position like this, it's 20 into 2, L into B, 40 meter square. Now let's do it for this horizontal thing. This is 30 which they have given, again this is 2 they have given. So 30 into 2, 60, right? So addition is 100. If you choose option which is 100, your answer will be wrong. Because here in that case, this particular portion we are duplicating, this small square here, because that is there here also and here also. How can we take it two times? No, that is not allowed. So one time we need to subtract. So this is 2 meter, this is also 2 meter, 2 by 2 it is. So 2 into 2, 4 meter square, we need to subtract once, because that is included in this also and this also, duplication hai. So we are reducing one time. So 96 meter square is the answer. The shaded portion has the area which is equal to 96 meter square. Okay, let's go ahead students, let's read the next sum. Find the difference in the areas of two squares, one with the length of side 6 meter and the other with the length of the diagonal 6 meter. See students, I told you all this is area is based on formula. Area, there are two squares. Area of a square is side square, or other formula of area is, area of a square is diagonal square upon 2, depending on what is given. Here in this case there are two squares with side 6 meter and another one is diagonal 6 meter. So obviously accordingly we will change the formula. Here area will be side square, so it is 6 square, so 36 meter square. Now here diagonal is 6, so d square, so 6 square upon 2, that is 36 upon 2, that is 18 meter square. So the area is different even though diagonal and sides are same. So we need to find out the difference between the two. So that is very simple. Answer is 18 meters square. If you know this and this, next job is very very easy. I repeat, you should know the formulae. Let's go ahead. Read the next sum which will appear on your screen. The perimeter of a semicircular garden is 108 meter. What is the area of this garden? Perimeter of a semicircular garden is given. So we must find out the formula. Write down the formula of a perimeter of a semicircular garden. That is pi r plus d, that is diameter, or 2r, 2 times radius. Okay, this is the perimeter, which is given as 108, which is given as 108. Now here r we can remove common. 22 upon 7 plus 2 is equal to 108. So r is 22 plus 14 upon 7 LCM 7. So I have equated the denominators, is equal to 108. R into r multiplied by 36 upon 7 is equal to 108. So r is equal to 108 into 7 upon 36, reciprocal. 1s are, 3s are. You can do division with smaller numbers also, doesn't matter. So r is equal to 27. Henceforth, you can use this formula for a perimeter of a semicircular garden or anything, because this is a constant which you are getting when you solve this. So if you don't want to remember this, just remember this formula. R into 36 upon 7 is equal to the perimeter of a semicircular shape. Okay. Abhi R to mila. Abhi what we need to find out? We need to find out the area. Once you know the radius, what is the formula? Again, you need to know the formula. Formula is 1 upon 2 pi r square of a semicircular garden. Okay. So this formula is half of circle. Circle ka area kya hai? Pi r square. Semicircular is half of circle. So half of pi r square. So 22 upon 7 here, and r we have found out 21. Preferably don't write 441. Write 21 into 21. So 7 3s are, 2 11s are. So what is remaining? 11 into 3 into 21. So 33 into 21 we need to do. So 63, 69. So meter square. This is the area. I told you, again I am telling you, these are all based on formulae. So you must know all the formulae. Then your job is very, very easy. Let's go ahead. Students, read the next sum. The length and the breadth of a hall are 18 meter and 15 meter. How many square tiles of length 25 centimeter will be required to be fitted on the floor of the hall? The hall is rectangular in shape with length 18 meter and breadth 15 meter. When we need to tile this hall, we need to find the area of this hall. Area of a hall is length into breadth, so it is 18 into 15. But be careful students, both these are meters, and the tile is square in shape with side 25 centimeter. So what will be the area of a tile? Area of a tile will be side into side, because that is square in shape. So 25 into 25, but these are meter and meter, these are centimeter and centimeter. So first we need to convert this into centimeter. How can we do that? 18 meter is 1800 centimeter and 15 meter is 1500 centimeter. Okay. Now we need to divide this hall in small tiles. Indirectly we are dividing this area of hall into this small tiles. So we need to divide the area of hall, which is this, by area of tile. Now everything is into centimeter, so no tension. we have converted meter into centimeter. Now everything is into centimeter, so we can go ahead with the division. 25 ones are, 25 six are 150, and this one 0. Then 5 fives are, 12 are, then 5 ones are, 5 threes are 15, 5 six are 30, and this 0. Then 12 into 360, how much it is? 12 zeros are 0, 12 six are 72, 12 threes are 36 plus 7, so 43. So these many tiles will be required. These many tiles, 4320 tiles are required to cover that entire area of rectangular hall. Okay students, let's go ahead. Students, read the next sum properly. In the figure, O is the center of two concentric circles. Length of OA is equal to 7 cm. Length of OB is equal to 14 cm. Find the area of the shaded region. Here, I have drawn the figure. The shaded region is this. This entire thing. Okay? This is shaded. We need to find out the shaded region. How can we do that? There is one way to find out the area of the big circle and find out the area of the small circle, and then you do subtraction. But that will take more time. So do we have another method to do this? Yes. There is a formula which is this. R is the radius of the bigger circle and small r is the radius of the smaller circle. So capital R is for bigger one and small r is for the smaller one. Okay. This we have derived from the area of this circle minus this circle. We have simplified that and we have arrived at final formula as this. Okay. So whenever we need to find out whether it is a road or whether it is just shaded portion, anything which is in circular portion like this, this formula needs to be used. Okay. Suppose circular garden is there and road is built, you know, inside it. Find out the area of that road, something like that they may ask. Okay. In that case also you are supposed to use this formula. Pi is 22 upon 7, big R is 14, so it is 196, 14 square minus 7 square is 49. So 22 upon 7, what is the, this is into here, what is the subtraction? 7, 14, here it is 1 upon, so 2's are and 1's are. So ultimately 22 into 21 is the answer. 21 2s are 42. So this is the answer. So centimeter square. This is the area of the shaded portion. We have just used the formula and solved it. Once you know this formula, this work is not difficult at all. Right? Okay, let's go ahead. Students, read the next sum which will appear on your screen. The lengths of the sides of a triangular field are 11 meter, 60 meter and 61 meter. What is the expenditure for growing grass in the field at the rate of rupees 10 per meter square? Students, here we need to find out the area of that triangular field. Why? Because we want to grow grass inside that field, right? So inside anything is area. Border is perimeter or circumference, right? So inside we need to grow grass, so we need to find out the area of that triangular field. Clever students will observe the numbers which are given to you. 11, 60, 61, they are Pythagorean triplets. In case you know that, 90% of the problem is solved. Okay? Pythagorean triplets means that triangular field must be in the shape of right angle. One side must be 11, other must be 60 and hypotenuse must be 61. immediately you will know looking at the numbers ki that triangular shape is right angle triangle shape hai wo field ka. Okay, once you know this, finding out the area is not a problem. What is the formula for right angle triangle ka area? Half into two sides which make a right angle. In this case it is 11 and 60. 11 and 60. Half into two sides which make right angle. So here now we will do the division. Ultimately 11 into 30, 330 square meters will be the area of, because everything is in meters, okay. So obviously this also will be 330 square meter, and the cost or the rate is 10 per meter square. So this is the area, area into rate, so total cost will be 3300. Okay, in case you don't realize they are Pythagorean triplets, then if the sides of a triangle are given, you can use Hero's formula. I will share that method also with you. Let's go ahead. Students, in case you don't know that Pythagorean triplets, don't worry, I will share another formula. S into S minus A, S minus B and S minus C, where S is equal to semi-perimeter, means 1 A plus B plus C upon 2, perimeter ka half, okay, that is S. Now what is A? A is suppose 11, B is 60 and C is 61. Let's go ahead, first find out S. This is called as Hero's formula or Heron's formula, okay. So S is equal to 11 plus 60 plus 61 upon 2, that is 132 upon 2, that is 66. Okay, now let us input this. S is 66, then 66 minus A is 11, then 66 minus 60 and 66 minus 61. Let's go ahead with the solution. 66, then here 66 minus 11 is 55, then here it is 6 and here it is 5. Now how to find out such a big number and then uska square root? It's difficult, isn't it? Not at all. See, 66 means 6 into 11, 55 means 5 into 11, and this 6 and 5 as it is. Now there are 2 times 11, so square root will be 11. 2 times 6, square root will be 6. 2 times 5, so square root will be 5. What is the multiplication? 11 into 30, so it is 330, which we had got there also in earlier method also, and rate is 10. So 330 area into rate, that is rupees 3300. Same answer with another method. Interesting, isn't it? Okay, with this we are through with this important chapter, area. This chapter is based on formula, so please revise all the formula, different shapes and their formula, because you will have to use them at the time of examination. Area is relatively easy and straightforward, no complications. If you know the formula, your job is very easy. Okay, students, if you enjoy my videos, then please share them with more and more students. And in case you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. I will come with the next video very very soon. Till then, what are you supposed to do? I think you all know by now. Study well, and very important thing is, yes, enjoy studying. Bye.